Good morning, students. Today, I will again discuss the lesson that is development. As I have explained that development is a very broad concept. Development can have different meanings. Development is the increase in income. Development can be increase in your career. Development can be increase in the abilities, skills. These all can be put together as development. If we talk about a country's development, development means the country's progress in every aspects: income, literacy, health, everything. So here we are going to analyze development. While we study development, we have to come to know different meanings of development and different aspects of development. The first aspect we have to analyze, that is, different persons can have different developmental goals. As we know that every individuals are different. Their taste, interest, everything is different. So, different people have different developmental goals. And development can be even conflicting. Conflicting means what may be development for one may not be development for the other. So, for one person, it can be something which can be development, but the same thing cannot be development for the other. For example, if we talk about a girl in a family who expects as much as freedom and opportunity as her brother. A girl who expects as much as freedom and opportunity like her brother. But her brother may not like this. So this is first example we have to study regarding the persons or different persons can have different developmental goals. Second example we can study, that is, industrialists may want more dams for electricity. As for industrial expansion, electricity is a prerequisite, or electricity is a very important factor for the industrial development. So they may want more dams for electricity, but it can submerge the land and disrupt the tribal people who have to displace. But this creation or development of dams, or making new dams which can submerge the land, and it can also disturb the tribal people because they have to displace the place, or they have to shift to that place. So it cannot be a development for a tribal people, but it can be development for industrialists. This is known as different persons can have different developmental goals. Next thing we have to study, that is, development is a mix of goals. Development is a mix of goals. People want not only better income, but also other important things in the life. People not only want better income, but there are many other things, many things which are other than income they want in their life. For example, if we get a job in far away place or very far off place, distant place, if we get a job, then we consider many factors other than income. First thing, that facilities for family, whether it is available or not, working atmosphere, how it is there, opportunity to learn, security, everything other than income we analyze. So before joining that job, we analyze many aspects. So this is known as development is a mix of goals. So development does not mean only income, but also development consider many other factors other than income. Now we can see how to compare different countries or states. If we consider to compare different countries or states, we generally take income as one of the important attribute for measuring development or to compare different countries and states. Income is one of the important attributes or important characteristics. Countries with higher income are more developed than others with less income. Countries which have more income, we say that it is more developed than countries with less income. And in this study, usually the average income is used to compare the countries. So usually when we compare the income of countries, usually we take average income. Average income is also known as per capita income. So average income we say, otherwise we say per capita income. And what do you mean by average income, or how we can find out average income? Average income is the total income of the country divided by its population. So average income or per capita income we can calculate by dividing the income, total income of the country divided by its population. Then we get the average income or per capita income. So income is one of the very important attribute or very common attribute to compare different countries or states. If we compare the average income, we can come to know whether the country is developed or not developed, less developed. So per capita income and average income both are same. Next thing that World Bank published report regarding development. In that World Bank criteria, they use to measure the development that they have analyzed, or they give some income which they have taken into consideration to measure the development. Countries with per capita income of US dollar 12,236 per annum and above in 2016 are called rich countries. World Bank classify rich countries and poor countries, or low income countries and rich countries. So World Bank is one of the international organization which compare the countries to calculate development. In that they compare the countries, rich countries and low income countries. How the World Bank consider or measure the development? Countries with per capita income of US dollar 12,236 per annum and above in 2016 are called rich countries. So in 2016, according to that, this is the figure, that this is the per capita income that they consider. And countries with per capita income of US dollar 1005 or less are called low income countries. World Bank also consider low income countries as the per capita income US dollar 1005 or less. And where do India stands? When we compare less income countries and rich countries, India's position is low middle income countries. It's not less income countries, it is not rich country, in the middle, low middle income countries, because its per capita income is in 2016 was just US dollar 1840 per annum. So World Bank consider India as low middle income country because its per capita income is neither too low nor rich, nor it satisfies rich countries per capita income. So India lie in low middle income countries. Average income is one of the very important attribute for measuring development. But If we consider average income alone, development will not be complete, or the criteria of development will not be complete. So there are many other attributes we have to take into consideration while studying about development. Average income alone cannot satisfy the concept of development, because I have told you that development is a very broad concept. So these are the things that World Bank study, that is rich in countries and low income countries. The World Bank classify rich country and low income countries based on average income or per capita income. You have to keep it in mind, World Bank, which consider per capita income as one of the very important attribute for measuring development.